Victory。
不止在纽约市，对警方执法争议和结构性种族争议的反对呼声也持续在旧金山、西雅图、纽奥良和奥兰多等美国大城继续燃烧。德国民进周刊指出，在全美激情之中，绝望也正在美国整个社会中慢慢燃烧。
Stop. Stop.Stop, I have a right to stop you because you're being suspicious.
Well, okay.
Turn around. Turn around.
例如，许多执法案例纷纷重新被检视，包括这起23岁非裔青年被锁喉后致死，经270万人联署之后，科罗拉多州宣布重启调查。
Get on the ground.
I'm sorry, dude.
All right.
还有27岁拉丁裔男子洛佩兹，在祖母家中因异常的歇斯底里，被警方脸朝地上，戴上手铐压制长达12分钟。罗佩兹后来死亡，死因究竟是官方说的吸毒过量与突发的心脏病，还是媒体指出的警方执法过当致死？正反论战再战。除了对执法失信，对全美各地与南北战争支持蓄奴者有关的雕像和纪念碑也陷入了一波拆除潮。
Statues honoring Southern leaders of the Civil War are falling all over, driven by the movement to recognize injustices against black people. In New Mexico, violence broke out over the removal of monuments to a Spanish conquistador who brutalized Native Americans.
It's a monument to hatred. It's a monument to white supremacy.
In California, statues of a Spanish missionary were toppled. So was one to Union General and U.S. President Ulysses Grant, who led the fight to defeat the Confederacy, but owned a slave for about a year, and to Francis Scott Key, who wrote the Star Spangled Banner. He also enslaved people.
Do we think slave owners should have statues?
而美国开国元勋杰弗逊和乔治华盛顿雕像也遭推倒毁坏，理由是他们两人都有过奴隶。而纽约自然博物馆前的老罗斯福雕像，本是象征非洲裔男子与印第安人与他并肩作战的雕像，如今被认为是带着帝国主义与种族歧视意味。
The statue clearly, you know, presents a white man as superior to people of color, and that's just not acceptable in this day and age.
I can name Kung Flu.
但对全美这波弗洛伊德之死后爆发的分裂动荡，《纽约时报》批评，美国总统川普采取的策略是顺势而为，煽风点火，以支持武力暗中高举白人至上主义，操弄种族牌，并加以政治化。
So we begin, Oklahoma, we begin. Thank you, Oklahoma.
《纽约时报》就追踪调查，川普之所以选奥克拉荷马州的图尔沙作为3月疫情后的第一场造势地点，因为这个地点是1921年著名非裔富人社区黑人华尔街遭种族主义屠杀的地点。
They bombed.
They threw bodies in the river. They threw them in mass graves.
When the dust settled, some 100 to 300 people were killed.
Total devastation.Like a war zone.
这个伤口，土尔沙市花了119年来弥平，来向无辜受害者道歉。
I'm sorry, the press, the local police department did not protect its citizens during the tragic days of 1921.
但身为美国领导人，川普选在非裔美国人庆祝重要的六月节的周末，反客为主登门踏地，不谈道歉与种族和平，反倒高举自己与选票，对非裔美国人来说如同又被羞辱一次。
We had some very bad people outside. We had some very bad people outside.
My first reaction was how disrespectful. I felt like it was a slap in the face.
另外，包括《纽约时报》和《华盛顿邮报》都指出，正当美国众议院通过了民主党版被认为是史上最严格警察改革法案时，警察团体的游说领导人戈斯摩也正在白宫亲自会晤川普与司法部长巴尔， 呼吁并抵制相关的改革法条。据说已经获得巴尔亲自对哥斯摩保证，警方最反对的建立警员执法不当数据库与修改免责保护，共和党不会让法案这么走。
The Justice in Policing Act bans chokeholds, develops a national standard for use of force, limits the transfer of military weapons to police departments, defines lynching as a federal hate crime, establishes a national police misconduct registry, and limits qualified immunity.
President Trump sought to politicize the moment, tweeting, "Law and order, not defund and abolish the police. The radical left Democrats have gone crazy."
President Trump is again calling himself the law and order president and trying to cast Democrats who support the movement to defund the police as anti-law enforcement and radical.
We have to respect our police. We have to take care of our police. They're protecting us. And if they're allowed to do their job.
各方政治角力一网略下，让种族歧视与警方暴力执法两大难题仍无法预测将走向何处。据美国媒体 CNBC 统计，美国警政系统的预算连年高达$7亿，仅2015年一年就花了约1430亿美元，等于从1980年以来成长了超过200%。但是全美犯罪率其实反其道的下降，换句话说，预算有不合理之处。金钱之处及权力之处，美国根深的痼疾。民众需要被引导的失望与愤怒，现在皆处于危险的十字路口中。